When Volvo first launched the XC40 in India, it promised to create quite a stir, and it delivered on a lot of what it promised. It had the design, it was a good car to drive, and there was a lot of convenience and comfort on the inside. But the stir did not turn into quite the sensation that Volvo was hoping for, and one of the reasons could have been it was only offered in diesel. Now, Volvo is offering the XC40 R design trim in a petrol variant, and the smallest SUV from the company once again rises to challenge the mighty likes of the X1 from BMW, the GLA from Mercedes, and the Q3 from Audi. So, XC40 now in petrol, can it really deliver and put out that knockout blow in a segment which is targeted towards the aspirational millennials? We're taking a closer look at what this car is all about. The XC40 in its petrol version does not differentiate itself from the diesel in how it looks. And that works for the inherent Volvo character design. At a time when other manufacturers are going big with chrome, Volvo's R design ensures that chrome on XC40 T4 is a bare minimum, on the logo at the front and exhaust tips at the rear. The front grille is glossy black and is flanked by the signature Thor LED headlights on either end. The roof of the XC40 is blacked out, while the 18-inch alloys make a comeback as well. The rear too continues to feature the boomerang taillights, which have defined Volvo's SUVs for quite some time now. On the inside, the XC40 stays true to Volvo's commitment towards packing its car to the absolute brim. In fact, this car also borrows several elements from its elder siblings, the XC60 and the XC90. Soft touch materials are aplenty, with black highlights done extremely tastefully. The 9-inch vertical touchscreen on the center console has also been carried forward and remains as responsive as ever. It is the hub which controls almost everything, from nav and safety features to even the music. You can spend as much time as you want admiring how the car looks on the outside, but people at Volvo have spent the extra hour giving the XC40 quite the premium fit and finish as well. We're starting with the rear seat because it's quite the nice place to be at. There is a lot of room. Now, this seat is positioned for me, but even if the driver is a little taller than me, and there is a passenger who's a little taller than me, and I'm 5'8", by the way, they won't really have too much of a problem. There is that under-thigh support though, which is missing, and on the long drives, you would probably have wanted a little more support for the under-thighs. But overall, that's not the biggest complaint that I have as far as the inside of this vehicle is concerned. But yes, the windows are not the biggest, but the panoramic sunroof more than makes up for the airy feel inside the XC40. I'm not a big fan of this carpet finish here, which is pretty much all around the vehicle, which takes away what is otherwise a really classy, really premium fit and finish from Volvo. There is also the premium Harman Kardon music system that is all around this vehicle, which gives a nice punchy music tone to anybody who's interested in something like that. And the overall Scandinavian design of the vehicle is clearly visible. The boot of the Volvo XC40 is very versatile. You get 460 liters of storage space, and you can customize and tailor-make it as per your convenience. Just like how the proof of the pudding is in the eating, the real answer to how good the XC40 is in terms of how good the petrol is. Now, there's a 2-liter petrol engine inside this car, and frankly, and in the most simple way, it's not going to win you any drag races. But then, you will not take a Volvo to any drag race. Instead, the XC40 drives really smooth, really calm, in a very reliable, fun sort of a manner, not necessarily the sporty fun. XC40 gives you a commanding view of the road, and I really like how the driver's position is quite upright. The steering on the XC40 sort of corresponds really well to the petrol motor. It is slightly weighted, but not the kind of weight that will sort of bore you down. The suspension unit also is once again top-notch from Volvo, and it's a very reliable, smooth drive which, regardless of whether you're commuting in the city or out on the highway, it's going to be a nice, calm and composed journey for you wherever. The XC40 once again gets a long list of safety features. The SUV gets radar-based safety, which is highlighted by lane assist system, adaptive cruise control, collision mitigation system, ABS with EBD, 360-degree proximity sensors, tire pressure monitoring system, 6 airbags, hill descent control, reverse camera, and a whole lot more. The XC40, in its petrol version, takes what was already on offer in the diesel and builds on that. In fact, it takes a lot from the XC60 and the XC90, which is fantastic. And we're very glad that this car now is available in the petrol version. Can it actually emerge as a very, very strong contender in its segment, like the XC60 is in its own segment? Time will tell, but direct rivals should be very, very cautious. What did you think about this car? Do let us know and follow us on Facebook and Twitter for all such in-depth reviews and details. Thank you so much for watching.